here with Scenester TV inside the lovely state of Jeffrey Levy, here with David Arquette. We're about to go inside and find all about your new flick.
The Key.
So we're here for a debut of an experimental film festival that's coming out this November, the 21st to the 28th. And can you tell us about that? How did that get started?
Experimenting is what it all is about. Not just experimental films, content-wise, but experimenting with means of distribution, means of post-production, means of production, everything, the entire process of filmmaking, experimenting with how to do it, and how to do it now, and how to make it work.
What are some of the challenges you guys went through during this process?
Everything.
Yeah.
It's all challenging. There's always problems. But if you have great collaborators, especially people like David, I could not have done any of this without David. David was really, really important to this whole process. If you have a great collaborator with your actor and your actress and then crew, that really helps a lot.
So you have two films coming out. You have The Key and mm-hmm. Me. David, you star in The Key as a lead. Can you tell us what the film is about?
The film's about the relationship between husband and wife and the complexity of their, sexual connection and his desire to please her. It really explores the complexity of a relationship in general and just how he could probably explain it much better than me. For me, I just really sort of gave myself to Jeffrey and just, you tell me, what you want me to do, where are we going with this? And I knew he's such a visual director, and he's truly an artist, and it's more of an art piece than anything else. There was just some really interesting scenes. We had one scene where he literally, set up the cameras, and the crew all left. It was just me and Bai, and it was shooting high speed, so he shot for like an hour, and we're sitting there having to sort of fake make love and, play around and just talk and just have fun. It was really, I'd never done that before. And different scenes like having sex and put us on a huge like spindle where we're just spinning around super fast on this bed, like striking these sexual poses. It was really, it's an art piece. It's something that no one but Jeffrey could have done. He's such an artist and a visionary. So it was a real treat to be a part of that.
And then the second film you have coming out is called Me, and that one actually I read in the green room, and I mm-hmm. thought that was very interesting. Can you tell us more about that?
Well, Me was kind of this warm-up. I started this studio, I'm going to make more films, and the key was my first official film, but I wanted to experiment with my equipment and my my studio and the property and so forth, and see if I could actually make something. So I started. Me was sort of this goofy thing, and I'm kind of like that character. I was a burnout from television. I'm a recluse, and it just happened by accident, and it was a big test, and it actually started turning out funny. So I ended up making, Susan and I ended up making a whole movie out of it, and it came out pretty funny. And so then I knew I was ready to do The Key after that. That kind of set everything in motion and told me that I could really make something as complicated as The Key, which is extremely complicated. Was an extremely complicated exercise in filmmaking.
And you filmed everything here on property?
Both films were filmed entirely here on the property. Everything I have, I've turned this property into basically a micro-budget motion picture studio.
Wow, impressive. Mm-hmm. And for this film festival, what is the criteria for the submissions, and how are the winners chosen?
Oh, it was random. We wanted to do something. We don't understand how a film festival can choose 100 films out of 10,000 submissions when there's 5 people choosing films. We really don't understand that. So we decided we were just going to choose people out of a hat.
Oh, wow.
Not based on any kind of objectives, any kind of criteria other than complete randomness. Which is how we did it.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if someone wanted to submit for the following year, how do they follow up?
And well, I think we're going to actually take this around. The thing is, I'm trying to buy this theater called the Fine Arts Theater. I'm putting together a group of investors where we're going to do this 365 days a year.
Wow.
It's all going to be devoted. The venture will be non-profit company. And so if you're an independent filmmaker and you've been turned down by everybody and you can't get your film seen, you can show your film. We'll show your film no matter what. We'll screen your film. It'll be... So that's, this is sort of kind of a test run to see if I can, if that will work, and then I can, it'll help me raise money for that project. I think we need something like that in Los Angeles, and Los Angeles is a really good place for it.
Absolutely. We also know that you have a nightclub, Bootsy Bellas. Do you think you'll use your nightclub for the next project?
Well, if you ever need a nightclub to shoot in, it would be amazing. It's right down the street.
We're actually doing a TV show called The Real Reality of David Arquette, and it's all about David. Sort of about David. We're not sure if it's real or not real, but I think Bootsy Bellas will probably figure in as some kind of character in the show.
Very cool.
How might this kind of studio model that you're setting up suggest like an easier democratization towards cinema, like for emerging artists?
Well, I think that's what it's really all about. The key thing, though, with the democratization process is finding means of distribution. Okay, making the films has become much easier, but now you got to get them out there and you got to get them seen. And I think we believe, I don't know if you've seen our manifesto, but I think there are viewers for everybody's films. You just have to figure out how to find them. And I think there needs to be some kind of hubs or some kind of process. And when I was talking about experimentation, that's what this is about. Experimenting with ways to find means of distribution for small filmmaking. I personally don't want to see superhero films all the time, which is basically what's being made at the studios, you know, comic book and superhero movies. I've always liked more personal, smaller films. That's what I like. And I think a lot of people feel the same way. It doesn't matter if enough people feel the same way, there will be. But you got to find those people, and we need to figure out ways to find and kind of group that whole thing together. I don't know if I'm making sense, but we're kind of trying stuff out. And I think having this project of the theater that shows movies, it's a calendar theater. Like, you get to play your movie for one or two nights, and it's a film festival. Filmmakers come and speak. There's a coffee shop. People go there and actually, as opposed to online, you can see stuff on a big screen. It's digitally projected. I think that's an amazing thing to have in a city, and every city should have it, especially Los Angeles.
Excellent. Yeah. That's all our time for today. But
thank you for watching Scenester TV.
Wow, thank you.
Thanks.